Hi everyone, this is Dr. Deeksha here. Welcome to a Patho MP4 on microsatellite instability and Lynch syndrome. Now, every time we talk about Lynch syndrome, we take you back to microsatellite instability. So I wanted to tell you what it actually means. Now, in front of you is our genome, which has these green sequences that I've marked, which are repetitive DNA. They have GC or AT sequences. Now, if I were to isolate this from some cells and put them in a test tube, the entire genome, and then if I were to centrifuge it, when I would do that, I would see that there is a bulk of the DNA that gets separated, and then there are these a little further away in density because they have repetitive GC or AT sequences, which were then we call them satellite sequences or satellite DNA. Now this repetitive DNA, also what you know as VNTRs, variable number tandem repeats, depending on how much repetition is there, could be called microsatellites. 1 to 6 is what most authors agree on, and a slightly longer sequences are called mini satellites. So from that we can understand that we could have dinucleotide, trinucleotide, which should put an alarm bell in your head, tetranucleotide repeats, pentanucleotide repeats, and hexanucleotide repeats. Now if we go to the cell cycle, as I'm sure all of you can understand from this, the cell cycle, S phase, G2, M, G1, G0. Now, in the S phase, we know that replication occurs in the S phase. When this replication is occurring, DNA polymerase has a tendency to slip when it's trying to replicate the repetitive sequences. Imagine it's something like, you know, you read something for lots of times and you go like, ye to aata hai, I know this, ah, this again. So DNA polymerase is also something like that, a little tired and goes like, oh, I've done this before. So it sort of tends to slip, which means that there will be some mismatch problems. And this is what is usually repaired by mismatch repair genes, MMR genes. I'd like you to meet the four most important MMR genes, MSH2, MLH1, MSH6, and PMS2. Now let's imagine a condition where either there is a mutation in any one of these genes or there is hypermethylation occurring in any one of these sequences. What that would mean is if there's a mutation, you'd get an abnormal protein or a missing protein. If there is hypermethylation, that would silence the gene, thus resulting in no formation of the protein. Now, when this happens, what would happen to our four MMR genes? They will become useless. They've lost their tools. And this is what we call MMR deficiency or MMR defects. Now, when this happens, if MMR is not able to work, when replication is taking place, the repetitions tend to increase and the mistakes are not fixed. This leads to a disease which could be familial if it's inherited or sporadic if it is acquired. Now, one example of the inherited diseases are your trinucleotide repeat disorders like fragile X syndromes, which occur due to CGG repeats, Huntington due to CAG repeats, myotonic dystrophy due to CTG repeats, and Friedreich ataxia due to GAA repeats. But the more commonly one associated that you read is Lynch syndrome, that we also know as hereditary non-polyposis colon cancer. This is an autosomal dominant condition. In this patient, he's born with one mutated or non-functioning allele of one mismatch repair gene. And hence we will say that he's born with increased risk of many cancers. And as expected with inherited cancer syndromes, this one is also affecting young people. The presentation is at a younger age as compared to that of the sporadic cancers. Now, as far as risk is concerned, I'd like you to imprint this image in your head. MSH2 is associated with maximum risk, MLH1 little less, even more less is MSH6, and finally the least is with PMS2. The cancers that you can see in this patient affected with Lynch syndrome, the most common one is of course colon, hence the name, but the most common extracolonic one is in the endometrium, stomach, small bowel, ovary, liver, gallbladder, the hepatobiliary, pancreas, urinary tract, brain, skin, prostate, almost any can be involved. Now, I just want to give you one more term here, and that is, in case a patient has sebaceous skin tumors and any internal cancer, this combination is called Mutor syndrome. And if that internal cancer or Lynch syndrome cancers, as we've seen in association, even then you're going to call it a mutator syndrome. But my point is that Lynch syndrome patients may have mutator syndrome, but not every mutator syndrome patient has Lynch syndrome. So I hope you understand the difference. Mutator can be a variant of Lynch in which sebaceous skin tumors are also present. Now, if we go to the colon cancer occurring in HNPCC, it tends to have some very specific features. Like in front of you here, I hope you can make out that these are the glands, the tumor glands, but in between, there are some cells, their nuclei with a little bit of retraction artifact around it. These are T cells. These are T cells. That's how I recognize that these are called tumor infiltrating lymphocytes. Again, look at this photograph here. You can see a lot of pink area. This is the muscularis. You can see very ill-behaved, battamese, ill-disciplined glands here invading. And at all of their invading edges, I can see a lot of blue. All of this is also tumor infiltrating lymphocytes, except that this is also resembling a little bit of Crohn's disease because of its rich lymphocytic infiltrate. If you look at the colon cancer occurring in Lynch syndrome, there are some features on microscopy which will prompt us to think of, could this be a Lynch syndrome colon cancer? Like tumor infiltrating lymphocytes, Crohn's disease like reaction, poor differentiation, signet ring cell morphology, or even mucinous morphology. Usually it occurs on the right side, proximal colon, and it tends to have slightly better prognosis as compared to the sporadic colon cancers. Now in front of you is a photograph of IHC done in these cancers, in which you can see this is a case in which IHC, remember, brown is positive, blue is negative. So I can see a lot of brown, but that brown is not in the tumor. This is the tumor, which appears to have no brown. The brown that is positive is in the stroma, which means those are normal cells. But what has happened in the tumor cells? There is absence of MSH2, there is absence of MLH1. These same tumor cells, however, are expressing MSH2 and PMS2, which means that these two genes are normal in this patient, but these genes are clearly absent or not functioning, which is why the protein that they make is absent and hence it is negative on IHC. So this was a quick review of microsatellite instability. In the next videos, I'll talk a little about how the pathogenesis of colorectal cancer occurs, the different pathways. Do leave comments on how you found the video, if it was helpful, and please let me know what other material you'd like. All the very best.